Hello everyone and welcome to rural Germany. In today's video, we are going to start a new city in the region that we are building in this series. In the last episode, we already built a train station for it, but today we're going to build up our city center and some surrounding houses on the other side of the train tracks. We are going to build a big church, a central square, a police station, a town hall, and a few highly detailed house blocks. You already saw me build the church, which consists of the town hall of Münster, a city in Germany, with a tower that is part of the castle built 2 episodes ago, moved inside of it. Now we are placing the houses that will go around the central square, and actually building the central square with a lot of brick decals. The houses in this town will be more closely packed than in the other towns that we've built so far, because this is meant to be a little less rural than the rest of the series. So yeah, it is a bit confusing, rural Germany with a city, but the city isn't going to be that big. And in the region in Germany where I'm basing this build off, the Eifel region, there are a few places that are bigger than a few houses too. So while we are detailing this central square, let's talk about the name of this village. The town will be called Weißenburg. This refers to the white castle that we built 2 episodes ago and is standing on the hill behind this town. And to prove this is realistic, after recording this episode and already giving the names, it was actually my own idea, not stolen from a real name. I was wondering if there would actually be a town called Weißenburg or a castle called Schloss Weißenburg. And yes, there is. In the south of Germany, there is a town called Weißenburg. And in the east of Germany, a completely different place, there is a castle called Schloss Weißenburg. So to come back to the game, this city build is probably going to take multiple episodes. Actually, I'm sure it will take multiple episodes, because I already recorded 3 of them, and there's still plenty room for expansion in the town at that point. I really wanted to build a city that I could spread over multiple episodes, just like I did with the first town in the series, but even bigger. So I could actually focus on different parts of the city. For example, the next episode is going to be all about the commercial district. And before this, I was usually just finishing 1 town per episode, which was pretty much the same all over again every time. So the towns became less and less special. I'll say it once again though, this won't be a really big city, at maximum only a few thousand residents, like 2 or 3, maybe even less. So don't worry about it not being rural, it's just a kind of central town in the rural region around it, and we'll definitely showcase that by plopping smaller towns here and there everywhere around it. So yeah, that's why I decided to do a somewhat bigger city, and I hope you like the idea. For now, we are working on a little corner in the back of the central square, which I can imagine is pretty forgotten by tourists, so the residents have a pretty silent life. So I think this is one of the ideal places to live if you want to live close to the city center, but don't want to have the noise pollution made by tourists. For example, later in the episode, we are going to make a similar street which just goes behind the main roads. But the big difference between this one and that one is that that one will be the main pedestrian connection between the train station and the central square. So that will probably be really busy. Here we are building a little pedestrian shopping street which runs next to the church and which I can imagine used to be, back in the day before cars existed, the main road through the city leading from north to south. It would be that main road where farmers transport their goods for the weekly market on this central square, and this shopping street is one of the remains of this old street. You can also see that the houses are really close to each other here. The street is pretty narrow, and that is pretty common in these older towns, which shows that this is really one of the oldest streets in this entire town. Here we are creating a little pub by placing a few standing tables and a little sign that is sticking out of the wall of this building that shows that this is a pub. Over here we use a ploppable logo of the Sparkasse, which is a bank in Germany that you find everywhere, in the city, in the rural regions. At least in my experience, you just find them everywhere. So I decided to add one over here too. Over here we are creating our town hall by scaling down this building that is obviously way too large for the scale that we are building our city on, and then placing them in a square form so that it looks like a bigger building. I didn't have any good town halls that fit this city, so I decided to do it this way. After we've finished creating this building, we will detail the part of the central square in front of it, and then go on with placing some more houses on the edge of the square to fill it up. As you can see, this is the continuation of that old north-south road that I was talking about earlier. But as you can also see, this part did get asphalted because it was slightly wider than the south part, and because it was needed to get to the central square from the main road. Obviously, there are other ways to connect from there, but the people that are living on this road also want some road access. And the reason why the south part wasn't made car accessible too was because that would mean a second road through the main square, and the road was just really narrow there. Also, at some point I want to do an episode, kind of an in-between episode, of just a lot of random clips of me fixing up small things in this build that we did wrong and I said I would fix later on, but because we never returned to that place, it never made it into a video, or I just never did it. And I want to ask you guys to remind me to add more of these bottom floor only shops to this city center to make it look more realistic. It's just a small thing, but maybe if we end up live streaming in this series, just post it in chat so I remember, and maybe we'll just fix it on stream. I'm not promising a stream here, but if we do, it would be an option. Here we are starting to work on the police station. As you can see, it is a pretty rural police station and it's not modern at all. Unlike the fire department, which we will build in the next episode, the police didn't get a new, bigger and modern facility yet in the commercial slash industrial district on the other side of the train tracks, but they are trying hard to get permission to build a better and bigger office somewhere in that district. Probably somewhere next to the fire station, because there is enough space. The leaders of this town, however, say that they would rather keep the police close to the town center because sometimes things happen there, and then it is really helpful to have the police really nearby. A second advantage is that this police office has a really strategic position that it can quickly block the only tunnel under the train tracks. If, for example, a car is being chased, they can quickly block it there because there is no other way for the car to go. It has to pass through that tunnel or it won't get on the other side. I hope you enjoyed that little time lapse of me detailing out this last few blocks of houses for today, as well as creating this little alley that leads from the central square to this other road that runs kind of parallel to the main road and is the main route for pedestrians going from the station. They will pass the police station and then go via that alley to the central square. Anyways, that's it for today's episode. Next episode should be up next week at the same time as this week. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure to leave a like and subscribe. Thank you for watching, and as always, enjoy the cinematics.